Okay, Assalamualaikum and good afternoon. I think we can start now. Okay, so today what we are going to do is that we are going to discuss the answer for our exercise 3, which I have given you yesterday. Okay, hopefully you have tried to answer the exercise that I've given you, so that we can see whether you got it right or not. Okay, so today is our last class, okay? So that's why saya letak background saya di tepi pantai, okay? Nak bercuti tapi tak dapat bercuti. Alright, so okay, share the screen first. Okay, so this is the exercise that I've given you yesterday. Okay, so this is the financial statement of Aziq RB Sdn Bhd for the year 2016. The first table is a balance sheet. Okay, this is, as I mentioned yesterday, this is the actual financial statement of Aziq RB. Yeah. Okay, bukan saya buat sendiri. Okay, ini memang saya ambil daripada website Aziq RB. And then I give it to you to calculate the financial ratio. Okay, so the first table is the balance sheet. Okay, as you can see in the balance sheet, there is a section for asset, and then for liabilities. Okay, okay, asset ada non-current asset dengan current asset. Okay, and then liabilities also the same, the non-current liabilities and also the current liabilities. Okay, jangka masa pendek dan jangka masa panjang. And under balance sheet also there is an equity in the section, okay, which is the shareholders punya equity, right? And for table 2 is the profit and loss account. Okay, so here you can see that the gross profit, profit for the year, which is the net profit. Okay, and this is the revenue or the sales. For table 3 is the cash flow statement or statement of cash flow. Okay, so here as you can see, this divided to 3 part: cash flow from operating service activities, then cash flow for investing activities, and the last part under cash flow statement is the cash flow for financing activities. And then last kali dah ada cash and cash in hand lah, cash and cash equivalent at the end of the year. Okay, what you need to do is that you have to calculate all the financial ratio that we have learned yesterday. Okay, ada 12 semua sekali. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, the 12 ratios that we have learned yesterday, which cover 4 categories of ratio. Okay, which are liquidity, debt management and asset management, and the last one is profitability ratio. Okay, semua ni cover all the ratios yang kita belajar yesterday. Okay. Okay, ada siapa dah try? Anyone?
Sampai setengah aja.
Sampai setengah aja dapat cuba. Right, can you see my slide?
Yes, you can.
Alright. Okay, so this is the thing that you need to calculate. Okay, you have to calculate all these 12 financial ratio from working capital until ROCE, return on capital employed. Okay, kita tengok yang pertama, which is working capital. Alright, so this is the formula: sales divided by working capital, then the value of the sale. I refer to table 2. Okay, sales ni sales ni sometimes dia guna terms revenue. Okay, kadang-kadang you cari dalam table 2 ni tak jumpa sales. Okay, so sales and revenue is the same. And kadang-kadang dia tulis sales revenue. Okay, kadang-kadang dia tulis sales saja, kadang-kadang dia tulis revenue saja macam ni, ataupun dia combine sales revenue. Okay, it's the same. Okay, so this is the value. 1,273. So, ambil value ni, so, masukkan kat sini. Alright, so working capital, macam ni nak calculate working capital? Seorang semalam, apa tolak apa?
Current asset tolak current liabilities.
Yes, current asset tolak current liabilities. Okay, that's how you calculate working capital. Current asset minus current liabilities. Okay, refer to table 1. Okay. Current asset 1,843,795. Current liabilities is 1,039,855. Okay, dia tolak dua ni. Okay, macam ni dia dah siap bagi dah, dah kirakan total. But during kadang ada juga financial statement atau balance sheet yang dia tak total kan. Okay, ada juga macam ni, dia bagi current asset je. Okay, yang ni tak ada. Total current asset ni tak ada, total asset pun tak ada. Sama juga dengan total dan current liabilities, total liability ni semua tak ada. Okay, maksudnya dia tak tambah kan. Okay, dia just tulis je kat situ. So means that you have to total up lah. Okay, so you kena tengok betul-betul. Ambil dua value tu, masukkan tolak and divide dengan one sales ni 1.2 million something ni, divide by the value that you get here, then you will get 1.49 times. Okay, ini dia punya value of working capital turnover. So maksudnya dia kena rolling hampir 1.5 kali untuk dapatkan generate sale ni. It's quite critical lah, boleh katakan terlalu rendah. Okay, so dia kena make sure dia ada enough working capital so that they can generate this this amount of sales yang dia target untuk tahun 2016. Okay, ada yang dapat betul?
Betul.
Okay, betul. Tak ada masalah yang ni. As long as you know where to find in the table, tak ada masalah. Alright, next ratio that you have to calculate is the current ratio. The formula is current asset divided by current liabilities and the answer must be not less than 2. Means that kena lebih 2. Okay, tadi kita dah tengok current asset is 1.8 million something. Dia punya current liabilities is 1.03 million. Right, you divide these two, you will get 1.77 times. So, maksudnya dia punya current asset 1.77 times more than current liabilities. Okay, which is less than 2, means that it's not good lah. Means that this SARB masa tahun 2016, they have a low level of liquidity. Okay, remember yesterday I mentioned liquidity ni asset yang kita boleh cairkan, convert into cash dalam masa yang singkat. Untuk current asset, untuk current ratio dalam masa less than 1 year. Okay, untuk current ratio. So kita kena tengok banyak tak aset dia yang dia boleh cairkan dalam masa tak sampai setahun, convert into cash and use that cash money for other kind of investment and so on. Okay, it's quite low lah. Okay, for the year 2016 for ZRB. Okay, ni boleh? Tak ada masalah eh? Dapat?
Dapat sir.
Alright, yang ini tak ada masalah. Okay. Okay, next ratio is quick ratio. Ya, ini kita nak tengok juga liquidity asset in the organization. In this case is SRB. Tapi dalam ni kita nak tengok asset yang dia boleh convert into cash dalam masa kurang daripada 90 hari. 90 days. Okay, current ratio tadi less than a year. Quick ratio ni lagi cepat dalam masa tak sampai 90 hari. Maksudnya dalam masa 3 bulan dia boleh jual aset-aset dia dapat cash. Okay, so dalam ni formula dia kita kena tolak inventory. Sebab inventory is very difficult to be clear within 90 days. Very difficult lah, susah. So that's why we need to minus inventories. Okay, so value current asset dengan current liabilities ni tadi kita dah tengok. So sekarang ni kita kena cari value of inventory. Okay, inventory this one 12,222,000. Okay, ini bukan 1 juta ni, dia 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Ini dah 9, 10, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 jadi maksudnya berapa 18 juta ni. Okay, 18 18 million. Okay. Alright, so minus the inventory, 12,222,000. So then divide by current liabilities, you get 1.76 times. So maksudnya dia punya current asset yang berbentuk quick ratio is more than 1.76 times than current liabilities. So here the answer must be more than one. So here you get more than one. It means that SARB has a good liquidity level in terms of their asset that can be converted into cash within less than 90 days. So dia ada banyak aset dia yang berbentuk liquid yang boleh jual dalam masa tak sampai 90 hari. Okay, compare to current ratio tadi. Current ratio dia agak rendah. Okay. Alright, next kita tengok is debt ratio. Okay, so debt ratio, the formula here kita nak tengok how SARB manage their debt, manage their debt efficiently or not. So for the first ratio is debt ratio, we are looking at the relationship between total liabilities and total asset. Okay, so here I think is quite direct. So you refer to the table 1, okay, which is total liabilities 3,175,941 and total asset 3,564,288. Okay, so you masukkan dalam formula times 100% and you will get 89.1%. So dalam kes ni dalam kes ni makin tinggi percentage makin tak bagus untuk business. It's not good for the business. The higher the debt ratio, the higher the business will collapse. Okay, so makin tinggi risiko business tu. Alright, so in this case 89.1%. Okay, it's quite high lah. Okay, considerably high lah dia punya debt to debt ratio. Okay, so dapat yang ni?
Anyone? Dapat.
Okay, so dapat eh. Alright, 89.1%. Next ratio is debt to equity ratio. So now the next ratio ni kita nak tengok relationship between liabilities and also shareholders equity. Kalau tadi liabilities dengan asset, yang ni dengan shareholders equity. So value yang sama ni kita maintainkan. So sekarang ni kita kena cari value of shareholders equity. Okay, refer to table. Tengok total equity kat sini 388,347. Okay, tambah 0,000 belakang. Okay, masukkan dalam formula. So you get 817.8%. Betul-betul tinggi lah. Okay, so jangan terkejut kalau dapat more than 100%. Okay, so dia tak ada masalah kalau dia dapat tinggi pun sekalipun macam ni, itulah jawapan dia. Okay, tapi dalam case ni it's too high, it's not good for the business lah. It's very bad for the business. Okay, kalau you tengok numbers pun shareholder equity ni is quite low, agak rendah. So what you need to do is that you can advise the management of SARB to find ways out on how they can reduce liabilities or find ways on how they can ask the shareholders to put more money in their organization, okay, so that you can increase the shareholders' equity so that the volume of debt to equity ratio could be reduced. Okay, so that's the way you can advise. Alright, next we are going to calculate the inventory turnover ratio. So in terms of inventory turnover ratio ni, we are looking at on how fast we can clear up our inventory. Okay, berapa lama kita ambil masa untuk clearkan inventory kita. The faster the better. Okay, so there are two formulas yang you can apply. Okay, so as I mentioned earlier, yesterday untuk inventory turnover ratio ni, you gunakan formula ni saja. Okay, you remember this one, it should be okay. Okay, stock divide by cost of sales times 365 days. Okay, ini dalam days dia punya tu. Alright. So, stock you boleh dapat daripada table 2. Stock ni adalah entry. Okay. Stock dalam arti kata lain, dia adalah inventory. Okay, so dalam formula dia gunakan term stock. Tapi stock itu adalah inventory, bukan stock saham. Kalau tengok kadang-kadang dekat, table 1 ni, dekat equity ni kadang-kadang dia ada letak stock punya rate. Okay, so dekat sini pun kadang-kadang dia ada letak stock. Okay, so stock in this formula refer to inventories. Okay, you kena ingat tu. Alright, 12, 12, 2, 2, 2. Okay, and divide by cost of sale. Cost of sale, you boleh dapat daripada table tu. Okay, 1072870. Okay, even though kalau based on biasa Sammy dia ada kerja account lah, ACC. But I think part 5 kot nanti you belajar account, I'm not sure. Okay, untuk BCM tak ingat lah. Alright, and later you're going to learn about account punya subject. Okay, so kalau you tampak ni biasanya dalam ni, dia dalam bentuk formula, dalam bentuk kurungan ni, ini benda yang kita minus, kena tolak lah. So ini value revenue tolak cost of sale, you akan dapat this value. Okay, walaupun dia dalam bentuk negatif, maksudnya you kena tolak, tapi still dalam formula you tak ignore the negative value. Okay, so ignore the negative value. So dalam formula times 365, you will get 4.16. Okay, so after you get this value, you put this value in the second formula, which is average age of turnover 365 divided by inventory turnover ratio, which is this one, 4.16. So you will get 87.7 days ataupun kita gundalkan jadi 88 hari lah. Okay, so they take about 88 days to clear their stock, okay, to clear their inventories, okay, which is quite high lah sebenarnya. Okay, because inventory ni the faster the better. Okay, maksudnya show that your business doing well lah kalau you boleh clear up your inventory faster. Okay, ada yang dapat 88 hari ni lebih kurang? Ke confused dekat stock tadi? Ada dapat lah? Ha? Anyone? Tak ada?
Tak stock tu sir.
Tak tahu stock nak ambil apa. Okay, tadi emphasize again, stock ni adalah value of inventory. Okay, dia refer to dalam table 1, dalam balance sheet lah, inventories kita. Okay, stock ni adalah inventories, bukan stock saham dan sebagainya. Okay, dalam formula dia guna term stock, tapi dalam mana nak cari value dia, kita refer to inventories. Okay. Alright, next ratio that we are going to calculate is debt to sales ratio, atau nama lain dia, apa nama lain dia? Seorang?
Account receivable.
Yes, account receivable ratio. Okay, takut nanti dalam exam, dalam test ke nanti tiba-tiba keluar account receivable ratio. Okay, you tak tahu apa dia account receivable ratio ni. Okay, Cik Reza tak ajar apa. Okay, it's the same. Debtors to sales ratio or known as account receivable. Okay. Okay, account receivable ratio. Okay. Okay, debtors to sales ratio ni kita nak tengok ability of the company to collect the debt. Okay, collect debt. Okay, berapa lama dia ambil masa untuk collect hutang? Because it's normal in business ada orang yang berhutang dengan kita. Kita nak tengok berapa lama kita ambil masa untuk collect our debt. Okay, first, this is the formula. Debtors divided by sales times 365 days. Okay, so you refer to the table 1. Debtors. Okay. Alright, kalau cari dalam ni tak jumpa debtors. Tapi nama lain debtors tadi adalah receivable. Okay, so receivable, kat sini pun ada receivable. Ada dua amount receivable kat sini. Okay, 704 dengan 786, 517. Okay, you campurkan kedua-dua ni. Okay, oops, sorry. 704 campur 786. right? Divide by sales. Tadi sales kita dah tengok table 2 or revenue, known as revenue as well. Okay. So you divide times 365, you get 453 days. Okay. More than a year untuk diorang collect hutang diorang. Good or not? Bagus ke tak bagus?
Tak bagus.
Okay, it's not good for their business. Okay, dia ambil mas. Okay. It took more than a year to collect their debt, which is not good for their business. Okay, usually sepatutnya less than 42 days. Okay, berapa dia? Jauh beza dia. 42 hari dengan 453 hari. Okay, which is not good lah. So, the management should do something. Maybe they need to follow enhance their follow-up procedures. Or maybe they can consider to adopt factoring, okay, yang saya explain dalam video last week. Okay, lantik third party untuk collect their debt, okay, supaya dia dapat duit lebih cepat. Okay, next is creditors turnover ratio, or known as, yang ni saya lupa mention yesterday, account payable ratio. Okay, tadi receivable, kita nak collect hutang. Yang ini kita nak bayar, pay. Okay, kebolehan company untuk membayar hutang, pay. Pay the debt. Okay, so that's why dia guna term payable. Okay, tadi receive, kita nak receive hutang kita. Kita nak collect hutang kita. Sebenarnya kita, yang next one is about how the ability of the companies to pay their debt. Okay, so berapa lama masa dia perlukan. So the formula is creditors divide by cost of sales and times 365. Okay, so tadi terms creditors dalam table dia berkait dengan hutang. So kita kena tengok dekat liabilities. Okay, kalau you cari dalam ni tak jumpa creditors, so you boleh cari terms payable. Okay, sini ada payable dan sini pun ada payable. So these dua value you kena tambahkan. Okay, 57,800, 852,127. Tambahkan dua ni, divide by cost of sale. Ini pun you boleh dapat daripada table tu. Okay, cost of sale tadi ni 1,072,870. Right, masukkan times 365, you akan dapat 310 hari. Almost a year for them to pay their debt. Okay, this one is good or not? Bagus ke tak? Anyone?
Tak.
Okay, tak bagus untuk orang yang kita hutang. Alright, tapi untuk company kita boleh katakan is good lah. Okay, sebab kita
bagus.
Okay, kita ambil masa agak lama untuk bayar hutang, so that the money that we need to pay for the debt, kita boleh guna untuk benda lain. Okay, tapi secara tak langsung sebenarnya it's not good for our company's image lah. Okay, because it took almost a year for us to pay our debt. Okay, tak bagus untuk image kita, tapi bagus untuk business kita. Alright, dia ada dia punya ini dia punya apa orang kata pro and con lah. Okay, kalau you takes a long time to pay the debt, to pay your debt. Okay, next we are looking at the profitability ratio. First one, we are looking at gross profit ratio. Ini untung kasar. Okay, yang this one in percentage, the higher the better for business. Okay, terbalik dengan debt management tadi. Debt management, makin tinggi makin tak bagus untuk business. Tapi untuk profit, makin tinggi makin bagus. Right, so gross profit you boleh dapat directly daripada table 2. Okay, 128,403. 128,403. Okay, sales ni pun tadi table 2 times 100, you akan dapat 10.7%. Net profit, you tengok net income after tax. Okay, net income after tax. Okay, profit for the year ni maksudnya dah selepas solat tax lah, untuk bersih dia 24,617 divide by sales. Time 100, you akan dapat 2.05%. Okay. So for both, is quite low lah actually. Dia agak rendah. Okay. Dia punya profit. Sama ada gross ataupun net profit. Sebab kalau gross ni you dah dapat rendah, automatically net profit you pun akan rendah. Macam mana you nak naikkan net profit, you kena make sure gross profit tinggi. So, macam mana you dapat gross profit tinggi, salah satu cara dia you kena generate more sales. So, volume of sales ni maybe is not sufficient enough. Okay, you kena naikkan volume of sales you. Ataupun cara lain, you boleh kurangkan liabilities, okay, kurangkan company punya hutang, okay, so that you can get more profit in your business lah. Okay, so that's one of the way you can increase your gross profit. Indirectly will increase your net profit as well. Okay, because these two are interrelated, as I mentioned yesterday lah, berkait. Okay, tinggi gross profit, tinggilah net profit you. Rendah net gross profit, rendahlah net profit you. Okay. The next one is ROI, return on investment. Okay, ini kita nak tengok berbaloi tak kita punya pelaburan. Okay, the formula is net income after tax. Ini kita tengok tadi 24617 tadi. Total asset, yang ini you boleh dapat daripada table 1. Asset kita tambah untuk you. Okay, total asset, okay, 3564288 times 100, and you akan dapat 0.7%. Okay, which is considerably low lah sebenarnya. Okay, agak rendah. So sepatutnya in normal business ROI ni sepatutnya at least 10%. At least. Okay. And the last one is ROCE. Okay, ROCE ni in terms of pulangan. Okay, berapa banyak pulangan kita dapat setiap RM seringgit yang kita laburkan. Okay. So dia punya formula is net operating profit divide by total asset minus current liabilities. Okay, ini kita dah tengok tadi. Dah tengok tadi dia table 1. Net operating profit ni mana nak dapat? Itulah gunanya tadi, banyak guna table 1, table 2 je kan. Okay, kat table 3 ni lah kita boleh dapat net operating profit. Alright. Wait, table 3 tak pakai pun sebenarnya. Dia ada satu formula yang saya tak apply untuk semester ni lah. Okay. So 51730 ni. Profit from operating activities from table 2. Okay, actually kalau fokus on 12 formula yang kita belajar ni, table 3 ni sebenarnya tak ada, tak guna sangat. Okay, sebab saya ada yang few formula yang saya tak apply, tak ajar you this semester lah. Okay, so because most of them is for dia tinggalkan untuk master level lah. Okay. So table 2 is for where you can get the net operating activities ni profit, which is 51730. Okay, 51730. You take the value, divide by total asset, divide by current liabilities, you get 2 cents only. RM 2 cents only. Okay, which is also considerably low lah. Okay, labu singgit dapat 2 sen je. Okay, quite low lah. Okay, so kalau boleh dia nak increase, perhaps they need to increase their asset and reduce dia punya current liability lah, so that they can get more worth it in terms of their investment. Okay, here you can summarize the AZRB punya financial ratio. Okay, dia punya working capital turnover, kita tadi dah calculate dapat. Okay, 1.49, okay, which is quite low. Okay, because at one stage perhaps SRB could not sustain the sales. Okay, kalau dia punya, dia tak boleh nak generate more working capital, perhaps sales dia, dia tak boleh nak, tak ada duit nak rolling dah. Alright, for current ratio, we get 1.77. Okay, level of liquidity is below the standard, which is 2. So therefore SRB needs to increase their liquidity asset. Okay, so dia kena perbanyakkan asset yang dia boleh convert into cash dalam masa tak sampai setahun. Okay, acid test ratio or quit ratio, okay, kita dapat 1.76 tadi, okay, which is good liquidity. So dah ada banyak aset yang dia boleh jual dalam masa tak sampai 90 hari tadi. Okay, 90 days. Alright, debt ratio 89.1%. Okay, so the higher the debt ratio, increasing the business risk, okay, as I mentioned earlier. So here SRB perhaps need to investigate on how they can increase the asset. Okay, or reduce the unnecessary debts in their business. Okay. Right, debt to equity ratio, ini in terms of relationship between liabilities and also equity, agak tinggi, too high, 800 lebih percentage dia. So perhaps SDRB should encourage the shareholders to put more money or find a new shareholders, or perhaps you can use this solution juga, maybe they can reduce the unnecessary debts in their business. Di mana liabilities yang diorang perlu clear up, maybe they can clear up, right? Inventory turnover, the capabilities of the companies to clear their stock or inventories. Okay, it took about 88 days. Okay, so again, perhaps it's quite good lah sebenarnya. So, the SRB has the ability to clear their inventories. Okay, sebab kita tak ada minimum requirement dalam soalan ni. Okay. Next is account reservable, which is debt to sales ratio. Ini kebolehan company untuk mengutip hutang. It took 453 days, more than a year, okay, which show the poor management of SRB. They need to enhance their punya follow up procedure to collect their debt quicker lah. Okay, ataupun dia boleh, as I mentioned earlier, to apply factory, okay, appointed party to collect their debt. And then creditors to turnover ratio, yang ini kebolehan untuk membayar hutang. Okay, it took 310 days, okay. As I mentioned earlier, in way is good for SRB, but in the long run it could cause damage to the company's reputation lah. Okay, sebab dia ambil masa yang terlalu lama untuk membayar hutang. Alright, gross profit 10.7% saja, considerably low. Okay, perhaps they need to generate sales in order to generate more profit. Okay, so maybe they kena increase dia punya marketing strategy, promotion strategy and etc. Okay, so when your gross profit is already low, your net profit also will be low. Okay, it's quite poor, so perhaps they need to reduce unnecessary borrowings. Again, you need to generate more sales to get more net profit in future. Or you can increase your marketing and promoting strategies. Okay, so that you can get more profit for your business. Okay, ROI, okay, 0.7%. Okay, as I mentioned earlier, normally should be 10% lah. And ROI, so it's quite poor. So management should increase the asset of the company lah, so that they can have more return on investment. Okay, ROCE hanya 2 sen saja setiap seringgit yang dilaburkan. It's quite low lah. Okay, in terms of perhaps again they need to increase the asset and reduce unnecessary debt as well. Okay, so that's how you summarize your answer. Okay, because the question asks you to identify the strength and weaknesses of financial of SRB Sdn Bhd. So this is the way. Okay, you boleh buat dalam bentuk table ni ataupun straight away. Selepas you calculate setiap formula ni, you boleh directly comment kat sini. Okay, pun boleh. Okay, ataupun you boleh buat dalam bentuk table macam ni. Okay, it's up to you. Okay, saya tak ada limitation. Okay, tak ada mana yang saya suka dan sebagainya. Tak kisah. Janji you ada give comments on each ratio. Okay. Ada soalan? Million, okay, betul. Bukan tu. Saya jarang dapat duit banyak-banyak kan. So tak tahu nak kira dah. Alright, any question? Boleh? So the most important thing about this calculation is that you need to remember the formula. Okay, and you when you remember the formula, you know where to find the value for each formula lah. Okay, mana nak cari, nak refer to table mana dan sebagainya. Okay, sebab ingat asset dengan liabilities table 1. Sales, cost of sales, profit ke apa semua dekat table 2. Okay, sebab you kalau you tak tahu mana nak cari, perhaps takes time for you lah. You kena tengok semua table 1, table 2 payah. Okay, so you kena clear the terms. Okay, macam debtor to sales ratio, if we are using account receivable terms. Okay, creditors turnover ratio, we are using account payable ratios and sebagainya, that kind of thing. Okay, sabar. Nanti saya jawab soalan Haris Daniel eh. Sebelum tu ada soalan, sebelum saya jawab soalan Haris Daniel ni. For your test, for your last test. Okay, kalau tak ada, yes, there is a test for you next week. Saya dah buat dah dekat UFuture ni, sama juga macam test. Go to continuous assessment, assignment, Okay, this is test 2 lah. Okay, dah ada kat sini. So, you boleh klik. Yang ini saya attach PDF file. Okay, saya tak write down the question dekat section you future ni sebab dia banyak table payah. Saya buat dalam Word, convert to PDF, saya upload dalam ni so nanti you boleh download the question. Okay, kat sini. Test 2. So, masa dia pun sama 4 to 6, 15. Ini saya buka untuk you take attendance 3.45. Okay, dah buka 3.45 as usual. Okay, so you can see here 3.45 you dah boleh masuk untuk take attendance. So tak adalah kalut nak masuk attendance dan sebagainya. Okay, and it's in handwriting. Okay, so handwriting. So kalau lupa tambah dekat belakang, jawapan masih diterima ke? Okay, masih diterima lah. Okay, jangan risau. Okay, jangan risau. Contoh kita ni yang saya bagi ni, because it's a real company, it's a real value, of course number dia agak besar. Okay, tapi dalam test, dalam exam, tak adalah saya bagi nombor sebesar ni. Okay, jangan risau. Okay, saya just bagi paling tinggi pun 100 ribu je saya. Okay, tak ada sampai bilion, tak ada sampai trilion ke million ke, tak ada. Okay, paling tinggi pun 100 ribu kot. Itu pun tak ada saya rasa. Yang test ni saya tak ingat. Saya rasa dalam 10 ribu, 100 ribu je kot. Okay, so jangan risau number besar sangat, tak ada. Okay, ini untuk real exercise ni, perhaps is quite high lah, nak tunjukkan real case scenario lah. Okay, tapi untuk exam, untuk test, tak adalah setinggi tu. Okay, value dia. Okay. Alright, so that's your last test untuk next week. Okay, so please again, remember, I would like to remind you, make sure manage your time properly. Sebab you ada 2 jam 15 minit, I believe is should be enough. Sebab dalam kalau real exam, satu soalan you boleh spend 45 minit sahaja. Okay, sebab dalam exam tu kena, kalau sebelum ni lah, okay, you ada kena jawab 4 soalan dalam masa 3 jam. Okay, you boleh spend 45 minit sahaja each question. Okay, tapi ni saya dah bagi 2 jam 15 minit untuk you spend untuk satu soalan sahaja untuk you jawab. Okay, and then you boleh banyak, I think you have much time for you to scan and upload your answer lah. So please again, kena betul-betul tengok on your internet punya location lah. Okay, hopefully tak ada masalah lah bila dia upload dan sebagainya. Okay, kalau by 6:15 tu you have problem with the youth feature, maybe hang ke apa ke, so you can email me. Alright, itu last option eh. Tapi saya kalau boleh submit dekat youth feature sahaja. Okay, kalau tak boleh juga, yes, you can email to me, but please email also before 6:15. Okay, sebab kalau you submit lebih 6 suku, perhaps saya akan tolak markah sikit lah. Okay, so please manage your time carefully lah. Alright, so this is our last class for this subject, BCM 523. Okay, except you have one more test, you have one more exam for your paper 2. Okay, for your paper 2 only cover topic on economic assessment and so financial analysis. Okay, yang teori-teori semua dah tak ada dah. Cuma you focus on apa yang kita belajar from lecture 7 sampailah hari ni, lecture 11. Okay, so walaupun dia more calculation, still ada soalan on theory little bit eh. Especially on sources of finance yang saya share with you the recorded mission last week. Okay, so ada soalan little bit on theory. Okay, markah dia tak banyak lah. Theory 5 markah, calculation 20 markah biasanya. Okay, so ada 2 soalan, jawab dua-dua. Okay, tak ada option. Compulsory for you to answer both lah untuk paper 2 nanti. Okay, sama macam paper 1 lah, 2 soalan jawab 2. Paper 2 pun 2 soalan jawab 2. Okay, cuma portion markah untuk paper 2 agak tinggi. Okay, 60 markah untuk paper 2. Paper 1 itu 40 saja. Okay, 40% untuk exam. So bila convert exam nanti, paper 2 will be 20%. Paper 1 is 20%, paper 2 is 40%. So total 60% is your exam, for your exam, and another 40% is your carry mark lah. Assignment yang you buat sebelum ni, ada 2 assignment saya bagi, tutorial, tutorial 1, tutorial 2, and 2 test which buat total up your tutorial, your carry mark lah. So for your carry mark, I try to give your carry mark before exam. I try during study week lah. Okay, kalau boleh, insyaAllah lah sempat kot. Okay, masa study week tu saya akan bagi excuse me, saya akan bagi you punya carry mark lah. Okay, out of 40% berapa you dapat. Okay, sebelum exam. Okay, dah dapat jadual exam, timetable?
Dah, sir.
Dah dapat? Bila paper BCM 523? Saya pun tak tahu bila.
Last paper, sir. 22.
February?
Yes, last, February.
Last paper. Okay, uh-huh. Apa? So, I will remind the group later lah. Before, maybe 1 week before the exam. In terms of timing lah. Sebab timing tu nanti, sebab saya tak masuk lagi dalam future soalan tu. Timing tu berapa jam yang boleh, yang diperuntukkan untuk you jawab paper tu nanti. Okay, sebab ada dua soalan. Okay, maybe more than 2 hours lah. Okay. So, that's all. Okay, so during your, bila you buat revision nanti, tengok balik. Okay, every session I recorded, saya letak dalam future. Kalau you malas nak scroll dalam group, maybe ada some of it saya share dalam group, ada yang tak, saya ada recorded link, semua saya dah letak kat sini. Yang mana ada recorded adalah click here. Eh. You boleh tengok balik. Especially on our part paper tu punya part lah. Okay, you boleh tengok lah kalau you nak buat revision dan sebagainya. Okay, so ada apa lagi? Anything you want to ask, you boleh tanya. And perhaps calculation ni you kena buat more exercise lah. Perhaps after this, maybe you boleh try dengan soalan December 2016. Soalan satu. Okay, question 1, part C. Okay, kita ambil sini December 2016. Question 1. Question 1B, part C. Sebab dulu subjek ni bagi 3 part. Okay, so try buat ni. December 2016, question 1B, part C. Okay, try buat ni maybe dalam Monday ataupun early next week, saya akan bagi dia punya skema jawapan. Okay, saya akan post dalam group dia punya skema jawapan. But please try dulu. Okay, baru you boleh tengok jawapan dia lah. Baru you boleh tahu pemahaman you tekat mana. Okay, so try buat ni December 2016. Question 1B, part C. Tahu kan nak cari pasal exam question kat mana? Tahu? Takkan tak tahu lagi? Ke ada yang tak tahu? Anyone? Okay, so I think tak ada masalah untuk cari past exam question. So try cari BCM 523 December 2016 punya soalan. Buat question 1B part C. Try buat. Okay, and nanti saya akan bagi dia punya jawapan perhaps early next week lah. Okay. So anything else? Hopefully, saya harap-harap subjek ni semua lulus semester ni. Okay, walaupun tak pernah berlaku sebelum ni. Okay, tapi hopefully semua lulus supaya, sebab next semester kod ni dah boleh dah kata akan dilupuskan lah. Okay, so kalau tak, kalau 2-3 orang je repeat, perhaps dah tak ada kelas lah. Okay, kena belajar sendiri lah. Okay, so sebab dia selepas ni intake dia terus masuk CMA lah, kod baru. Okay, so kod baru ni, ekonomi ni dia dah move towards part C nanti. Okay, dia dah tak early semester dah. Dia move towards part C. Dah lambat sikit kajar. Okay, so so please, kalau boleh pass di subject. Yang mana repeat tu kalau boleh lulus juga. So hopefully tak ada yang repeat next semester lah. So that's my target lah kalau boleh. Yeah, wish you all the best for your test and also exam. Anything you want to ask me, you can ask in the group. Kalau tak nak tanya dalam group pun, you boleh PM me. Okay, tak ada masalah. Alright, so that's all. Thank you for your time and commitment. Take care and stay safe. Assalamualaikum.
Assalam. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.